at Ferguson Showroom with the one and only Chef Alan Wong. And I wish I could tell you what we're making today, but I don't even know what we're making. Will you tell me now? He's been very secretive.
No. Secret.
Okay, I'm going to get, well, I can't even guess. I see fish. I see a Snickers bar.
We're going to test your taste buds. And we're going to have fun.
Okay, I'm all for the having fun part.
Okay.
I don't know. I'm a little nervous about my taste, but let's see. So what are we doing first?
I'm going to... How do you make this higher?
Here we go. Yep. There we go. A little lower. Is that good?
Right there.
Okay.
All right.
Butter.
So a little butter. Go easy. All right.
That sounds good. Now, how are you doing? It's been a long time since I've seen you.
It's been busy.
Yeah?
Uh-huh.
We're talking about, of course, you've got the Alan Wong restaurant, but today we're talking a lot about the Pineapple Room restaurant. A lot of people may not realize they're actually open for dinner, too. It's very busy during lunch hour, but you also serve a great dinner.
Pineapple Room is open for dinner every night except Sunday.
Okay.
And then lunch every day, 7 days a week, and breakfast on Saturday and Sunday. Saturday, they open at 8 a.m. and Sunday at 9 a.m.
So it's perfect because you can go for breakfast, and then when the mall opens, when the stores open, you are right there.
Mm-hmm.
I like that.
Okay, so I'm just going to cook this really light. It's not going to be a hard sear.
Okay.
It's going to... I'm not going to try and make it brown, so that's why the heat is like on sort of like medium.
Okay.
So... just season with salt, real simple.
And now, is this a dish someone can actually make at home? I don't know. Everything always tastes better at the restaurant.
I tell you what. You know what the hardest thing to teach is? When you use your finger to test the doneness of something, this could be a steak that thick, could be a fillet of fish. It's the hardest thing because your finger goes straight to your brain and says, okay, I'm done yet, or it goes 30 seconds more.
Yes.
It's the hardest thing to teach, but I'll teach you that.
Okay.
Yay. So while this is slowly cooking, I want to do an exercise with you that is about taste.
Okay.
So here you go in one hand. Take one piece.
This has never happened before. Okay.
So now we're talking about taste, okay? So what you want to do is take a sip of the Coke.
Okay.
And in your head, register 1 to 10, 10 being the sweetest. Give it a number. You don't have to tell me. Okay?
Okay.
Now, take an equally proportionate bite of that, and same thing, just 1 to 10, how sweet it is. Okay? Then, swallow completely.
This is a very healthy lunch for me, Alan.
Okay. So now, take a proportionate amount of Coke again, and the question to you is not 1 to 10. Question to you is, does it taste different than the first time?
Mm. It tastes less sweet.
Less sweet?
To me.
You think it tastes like Diet Coke?
Does it taste like Diet Coke? Actually, it kind of does.
Okay. Now, taste that again. And the question is, does it taste different from the first time?
The chocolate?
Mm-hmm.
No. Same? Not to me.
So what do you think this tasted different the second time around?
I don't know. Because of this, obviously. Uh-huh. But what is this doing to this?
Because this has more sugar in it than that. And so when this has more sugar, this will seem a little bit less sweet than the first time around. Because the first time you had this, you didn't have anything in your mouth.
Right.
Right?
Yes.
And so the whole point is what you eat and drink before you eat something next or drink something next is going to change. Okay, so this is how we do food and wine pairings.
Okay, so obviously you should have something. What should you have in between to kind of clear your palate then?
Water, warm water, bread. But you know, like for example, when you go out to dinner and you have a great bottle of wine and you or a glass and you say, I want to buy that and drink that at home, and you go home, you open the bottle of wine and you're like, oh, it's not the same. Okay. You have to recreate the entire evening. Mm. Maybe you just ate a nice slice of steak or a piece of lamb or a piece of fish that made that wine really, really awesome. right?
That's so interesting.
And let's say you just had a peanut butter and sandwich and you did that, okay?
Probably would not taste the same.
Okay, so now I'm just gonna turn this over.
All right, Alan, we're almost out of time, but in our second segment, I wanna finish up with this fish.
Okay.
And then I also see some Simon noodles.
Yes.
From Hamura's, so you know it's gonna be good.
But the most important thing is a little taste test here.
Yeah. No, that's so interesting, because it's true. You want to clear your palate before you... It can affect what you eat.
So I'm going to tell you what the secret is. I'm going to plate this, and these are three different fishes, very popular fishes in Hawaii.
Okay.
And all I'm going to ask you is, which one do you like the most?
Okay.
Okay?
I'll have an answer for that. All right, we'll be back.
Talk about pressure.
Right?
Wow. Like,
once he told me that on air, I'm like, oh, well, what if I don't choose the right fish?
I know, no pressure. Kidding. And then the culinary journey that he just took you on, it's like, I mean, you were having almost like a pop quiz right there on that. That was cool, though, from Alan.
Actually, it was so enjoyable doing this with him because I learned so much in my short time with him.
And talking about learning from the best, I mean, that's
Alan. Yes, so I know.
It makes more sense that when you go to the, you know, especially restaurants, and they have the wine pairings next to the dishes. Now it's like, oh, okay, I understand why.
And he's so right about that, because sometimes you try and recreate something at home, or you buy the bottle of wine to have at home, and you're right, it does not taste the same
as with the restaurant. Gotta do the whole menu all the way through. Cool, Trini. I can't wait for the next part when you pick which fish.